We have a friend who went to Hawaii, and he sustained a head injury while he was there. And before he was well enough to come home, he had chalked up a bill of over $600,000. So what middle-class Canadian could absorb that?
I guess I feel bad that you would have to worry about something like that.
We're not criticizing your country. We're just giving you the facts that we could not afford to be without insurance.
Even for a day?
Even for a day.
To prove their point even further, they sent me over to a local golf course to talk to Larry Godfrey, who had a golfing accident while on vacation in Florida.
I could hear a noise and feel a pain, and the tendon snapped off this bone here that holds the bicep in place. So this bicep muscle was released like on an elastic, and it ended up here on my chest.
Muscle came right up your arm and ended up right up in your chest.
Ended up right here.
Like all good golfers, Larry finished his round before seeking medical attention. That's when he got the bad news.
I wasn't too worried because I had out-of-country insurance, but when he told me it was $23,000 or $24,000, then I
$24,000?
Yes.
So if you'd stayed in the United States, this would have cost you $24,000.
$24,000, yes.
And instead, you went back to Canada.
Yep.
And Canada paid
your total expenses.
Everything.
Paid for the operation.
Yes.
And it cost you?
Nothing.
Zero.
Zero. Zero.
I'm wondering why you expect your fellow Canadians
who don't have your problem, why should they, through their tax dollars, have to pay for a problem you have?
Because we would do the same for them. It's just the way it's always been, and it's the way we hope it'll always be.
Right, but if you just had to pay for your problem,
yeah,
and don't pay for everybody else's problem, just take care of yourself.
Well, there are lots of people who aren't in a position to be able to do that, and somebody has to look after them.
Are you a member of, like, the Socialist Party here? Or?
No, no.
Green Party?
No. No, actually, I'm a member of the Conservative Party. Is that bad?
Well, it's just a little confusing.
Well, shouldn't be. I think that where medical matters are concerned, it wouldn't matter in Canada what party you were affiliated with, if any.
But to us, as we look across the river here, you know, why don't you think we'd believe that? What's wrong on this issue with us?
I guess the powers that be don't share our beliefs that health care ought to be universal. I mean, Canadians didn't until we met up with a guy named Tommy Douglas, who pretty much changed everyone's mind. One guy did it.
Can he come over and visit us?
He's dead, unfortunately. Oh. In fact, he was. He's just most recently been revered as Canada's singular most important person. We think so much of.
I mean, in your history.
In our history.
Of your whole history.
In our whole history.
Tommy. More than your first prime minister.
Absolutely.
More than...
Yeah. Even more than Wayne Gretzky.
No way.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Great more than hockey Celine player. Dion.
Great singer. More than Celine. Yeah.
More than Rocky and Bullwinkle.
Maybe.